KPM PWM modulation and demodulation trainer kit. Order code is 40536. So this is the trainer kit. Here this is pulse output section. There are four type of pulse here. This is 8 kHz, this is 16 kHz, this is 32 kHz, and this is 64 kHz. This is the function generator section. First one is for square wave, 1 kHz and 2 kHz. The second one is for sine wave. Here we can have 1 kHz or 2 kHz. Using this toggle switch we can select the range. Now this is pulse amplitude modulation PAM. This is pulse position modulation block PPM, and this is pulse width modulation block PWM. This is a low pulse filter. This is AC amplifier. With the help of this knob we can adjust the gain. This is audio input block. This is switch fault. There are two types. There are two switch faults are here. These are the ground terminals. This is DC power supply, and this is audio output. This is the main switch to turn on or off the kit. User manual and adequate number of patch cords are included with this kit. And to perform the experiments, we will need a help of a DSO. Our first experiment is to study of pulse amplitude modulation using natural and flat top sampling. For this, we are going to build this connection here. So first, connect 8 kHz pulse output to pulse input and kHz sine wave to the modulating signal input. Now we will observe the output waveform at terminal 9 and terminal 7. So connect it here at the ground terminal and we will observe the output. So this is the output waveform at terminal 9. And this is the output waveform at terminal 7. Now observe the difference between the two output waveforms. Now slowly adjust this amplitude potentiometer and we can observe the changes in output waveform. Now change the frequency from 1 kHz to 2 kHz and again observe the output waveform. This is the flat top sampling. Also, you can vary the frequency of pulse by giving three different types of pulse input as we are using 8 kilohertz, now change it to 16 kilohertz and observe the output and both the terminals. Similarly change it to 32 kilohertz. Vary the amplitude potentiometer to get a stable output waveform. Next experiment is study of pulse amplitude modulation and demodulation with sample and hold and flat top sampling. So for this we are going to build this circuit here. So we will first connect 8 kHz to the pulse input and output sine wave output terminal to the modulating signal input. After that, connect the sampling output of PAM with low-pass filter input and connect the low-pass filter output to AC amplifier input. Now, we need to keep this gain knob at anti-clockwise position. Now, turn on the power supply. Now we will observe the output waveform first at TP9 and TP7. So now first we will test the, we will observe the waveform at TP9 and TP7. So this is the flat top sampling, TP7. Now, if we check the output output of the AC amplifier, we will see that we get the output waveform exactly like the input waveform. So this is the output waveform of AC amplifier. Now we will check the input waveform. This is the input waveform. As the amplitude is very high, so there is distortion and it looks like a sine wave. So if we, it looks like a square wave. If we adjust the amplitude, we will get a sine wave like this. And in the output also, output of the AC amplifier, we can see that the output waveform is exactly like the input waveform. Next experiment is to study PPM using DC input. So for this we are going to build this connection here. So we will connect the DC output to the modulating signal input. Keep this to minimum. Now we will observe the output. at TP11. So turn on the kit. Slowly increase the power. And we will get this type of output waveform. Experiment is to study PPM using sine wave input. So I am giving sine wave input 1 kHz to the modulating signal output input, and we will observe the output waveform. So this is the PPM output waveform. So as we are giving sine signal as an input, we are getting this output waveform as PPM output. Experiment is study of PWM using different sampling frequency. For this, we are going to build this connection here. So first, we will connect pulse output. Here are the pulse input of PWM, and we will connect the sine wave to the modulating signal input. Now we will observe the PWM output waveform. So this is the PWM output waveform. Vary the amplitude potentiometer and we can see changes in the output waveform like this. Also change the frequency range from 1 kHz to 2 kHz, and we can also see the effects of it in the output waveform. Similarly, we can also change the frequency of pulse output. So select 16 kHz. So this is the output waveform from 16 kHz pulse output. We can also select 32 kHz, 64 kHz, like this. Our next experiment is study of pulse width demodulation. For this, we are going to make this circuit here. So first, connect 64 kHz pulse output to PWM block in pulse input, and connect the sine wave output, 1 kHz sine wave output, to modulating signal input. Now we will connect PWM output to the input of low pulse filter, and we will connect the output of the low pulse filter to the input of AC amplifier. Now we will observe the output. First at TP16, in the low pulse filter output section, and next we will observe it to the low pulse filter input section, sorry, output section. So this is the output of AC amplifier. Now vary the amplitude of sine wave, and we can also see that the output waveform is changing. Also, change the frequency connected to 8 kilohertz, 16 kilohertz, 32 kilohertz, and observe the output waveform changes accordingly. Next experiment is study of voice link using pulse position modulation. For this, we are going to build this connection here. So first, connect modulating signal input to the output of audio input block. After that, connect the output of PPA to the input of low pass filter. Next, we will connect the output of low pass filter to the input of AC amplifier, and we will connect the output of AC amplifier to the input of audio input block. Now, we will connect a microphone here at the mic terminal. Now turn on the kit and adjust this gain knob to get a clear signal. Hello,
hello, hello, hello, hello, hello.
Also, you can see as we are using this microphone, we can hear the sound from the speaker. Also, you can use headphone and hear it through the microphone. So there is so much noise here. Use this knob to get a clear signal.